What's up, guys? I'm back today with another Pocket GM 21 video on the channel. And in today's video, we are going to be starting year number two. We're probably going to be going through eight games today. Going to be a quick one today, quick little video. Don't want to extend it too long. And then we'll do the next eight games in next episode. So we're going to check out the first four games, see how the team does, kind of see if we're looking to get rid of any players, pick up any players, and then we'll go from there. Send the rest of the three games, and if we want to make some trades before week seven, we'll think about it and check out how the team is doing after week seven. And then before we play week eight, so I guess we're going to only play seven games, so we'll play 10 games in next episode. Totally forgot, obviously, 17 game season, but we will be playing through seven games. We'll check out any players that we're interested in trading, and then we will potentially be doing that in next episode. So let's get started today. You guys know the team, 79 defense, 75 offense, 77 overall team. You guys know the team. We're going to be starting off against the Jets. We're going to sim through all these games. We take a first week loss. We'll check out some of the stats. You guys can see the team. Corey Van Noy, 15 for 30, 196. Not a great completion percentage. Do we have any turnovers? It looks like we had one fumble. We picked him off. We forced three turnovers, and we still lost this game. Very disappointing. We're going to head into week number two here against Pittsburgh, and we get absolutely crushed. We had 58 yards of total offense. Wow, Corey Van Noy, 9 for 26, 73 yards. That is possibly one of the worst games I've ever played or ever seen my team have on this game. You guys can see we had 11 punts. Absolutely terrible as we get shut out in week number two. And our safety is going to be out for a week. We're going to need to pick anybody up. We are not. We're going to rock with that. He's out for just 1 week. Head up to number two, and we are playing Seattle. A little bit better of a game. Corey Van Noy, 18 for 34, 185. Not too bad. Check out some of the turnovers here. So not great. We're starting off this year 0-3, and our starting running back is going to be out for 1 week. Not that he's had a great year, 2.4 yards a carry. Let's check out the backup, how he has done. He is at 3 yards per carry, so slightly better. We're going to sim through this last week, week number four, and we're going to lose 20 to 13. Close one there. And we do outgain them in yards, 310 to 287. You guys can see our quarterback throwing another touchdown, 26 for 49, 286, one touchdown. Not a bad game for him. Our running game is just not efficient. Mike Swift with 11 carries for 21 yards. Not exactly what we want to see on the team. Do we have any turnovers? We're doing pretty well in the turnover department. We're just not being an efficient offense. We're going to check out some of the stats really quickly. You guys can see we are in the bottom half of the league. 32nd offense, 30th defense. Not great. We have a not too bad rush defense, and our rush offense, 51 yards a game, is not cutting it. I mean, Corey Van Noy in four games doesn't have a turnover or doesn't have an interception. I mean, he probably might have a fumble or something, but he at least does not have a interception. And Mike Swift, 2 yards per carry. Simalo, however you say his name, 2 yards per carry. Receiving, not great. Josh Thompson, not having a great year either. Or at least he's leading the team with 166 yards. Not a great year for us so far. We have 3 sacks on the year. This is a bad team, and I expect us to have a bad, bad year. So we'll sim through the next week. We lose 16-8 against Baltimore. No interceptions again, 21 for 45, 237. They had 124 yards with one guy on the ground. Not great. Anything better? Mike Swift, a little bit better of a game. 9 carries, 65 yards. Can't complain there. Anybody crazy receiving? Wally's doing pretty well. 75 quick development. He's the rookie, right? And not too bad there. Any turnovers? No turnovers in this game. And we missed a kick, but so did they. So anyways, one of our closest games. I was hoping we were going to be able to win that one, but we will sim on to week number six. And we finally get our win, moving to 1-5 with a big win, 453 yards of offense against LA. And 4 touchdowns for Corey Van Noy, 21 for 30, 304 yards. And Simalo, that's all I'm going to say his name. We're going with it, with 91 yards on the ground. With a 5 average. Not too bad of a day. Much better day. 2 receivers with 55 yards and a touchdown. Joe Carey and Tyvus Boodle. Great name. Anyways, we'll check out any turnovers. Looks like we had... Did we have 4? Did we pick him off 4 times? We picked him off 4 times. Oh my... Wow. 3 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. Anyways, that's... I can't complain. We are on to 1-5 on the year. Do we need to pick up a cornerback? No. Our second corner is going to be out for 3 games with a calf strain. So Going to be okay. We're going to be a 78 overall, 80 overall defense, up a little bit, and we are going to be playing New England in game number 7, our final game of today. We come out with a close one, 24-20. Pretty close game there. And Corey Vinoy, another solid day. Not great. Obviously, the offense isn't going to be phenomenal. 15 for 24, 219, and a touchdown. Samalu with another great performance in back-to-back weeks. And that's going to be it for today's episode. I'm going to actually check out some of the stats really quickly. Looks like our offensive guard is injured, and our backup is not great, but we're going to have to run with it. So we'll check out some of the stats. You guys can see 31st in offense, 28th in defense. Our pass defense is getting a little bit better. Our rush defense very slightly better, but overall not great. But Vinoy, not too bad. What's his completion percentage? We don't have completion percentage, obviously. QB rating, 80.4. Better start than last year in 7 games. 125 or 238. Not phenomenal. Slightly above 50%. 1,500 yards on the dot and 8 touchdowns with 0 interceptions. Not too bad. I can't complain about that. Samalo definitely turned it up these past 2 games. 91 and 71 in back-to-back weeks. Mike Swift still averaging 3 yards a carry. Really hasn't went off for anything crazy. 65 yards isn't great, but that's his best game of the year. But he did catch a touchdown pass. And not too great there. Receiving Darius Benjamin leading the team. 85 quick development. Josh Thompson followed by DJ Wiley, Joe Carey, and Samalo. Sacks were left leading by 2. Wow. 3 interceptions, though. Is this a guy, our rookie? Is he our rookie? He is our rookie with 3 interceptions in 7 games. And Tralamarin with 5 for 10 on extra points. -1 fantasy points. You know it's a bad week when you get -1 fantasy points. But we're going to move on. We've already punted 53 times in 7 games. Not a great start. But we do have a W, and that's all that matters. So anyways, we are up to an 80 overall defense, 74 offense, 77 defense. We do have an injury to our offensive guard. But that is it. So far, injuries not too crazy. Not too crazy for the injuries, and we're doing pretty well. I'm content. I'm happy with the way Vinoy is playing, and I see some potential with this team. So, anyways, that is going to be it for today's episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. The next episode will include some trades that we're potentially going to make, and then also the rest of the 10 games for this season. And we'll probably send through the postseason, see who wins, and everything like that. So, that's pretty much going to be it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys did, please make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.